The entire town of Valentine was stunned at the murder of Sheriff Boomer. He was a well-liked and well-respected man in the community. No one knows who would have done such a despicable act.
Such a crime calls for the best of the best. I introduce Chief Investigator Nevis Glonk.
Our first suspect, the common criminal, Mr. Guster Brown himself. This is his story.
Lots of people wanted to see me locked up because of all the crimes I committed over the days. Everyone thought I was really good at poker, but in reality, I was just a no-good cheater.
This is baby.
How? You're cheating! You have to be cheating! No!
Big winner tonight.
Mr. Guster Brown, how are you?
You know, I could be doing better, honestly. Right now, as you can tell, I'm being interrogated for a crime that I haven't committed.
Yeah, okay. I could be squeezing the hog right now, but I'm not. I'm here interviewing you. I got a pig farm up in Wisconsin.
Sounds cool.
Yeah, let me ask a question. How'd you get the name Guster?
You know, just came out of the womb. Mom's like, he's a Guster.
That is literally the most idiotic, stupidest thing I've ever heard.
Can you not call my parents idiotic?
I'm just stating facts as they are. It's an idiotic name. Anyways, so you know why we brought you in? Yeah, we brought you in, right?
Yeah, apparently you think I killed someone?
Yeah, well...
I've killed many people.
So you just incriminated yourself.
We'll get to that later. Alright, okay.
So the sheriff's dead.
Yeah,
And you're in handcuffs right now.
Yeah. Typically when I get caught, I'll confess, because good job on catching me. I don't usually get caught, you know.
All right, did you kill the sheriff?
No.
Guster?
No, I'd be honest if I killed him.
I just don't believe you.
So, Mr. Glonk, what did you think about your previous interview?
Yeah, that dude. Everyone doesn't get it. He literally kills everyone. He literally did it. Okay, crime over. We're gonna hang him.
Guster Brown, you've been found guilty with the murder of Sheriff Boomer. You are hereby sentenced to hang.
Sir, no, I didn't do this. I didn't do this. I'm innocent. No, you can't do this.
Damn. I sure do miss Sheriff Boomer. Even though we didn't get along, he stole a place in my heart. I don't feel like you got to the bottom of that case. I'm gonna look more into it. Maybe I can find something. What's this? Oh my good baby Jesus. Guster Brown was in jail the night of the murder. I'm gonna get rid of Nebus Gonk immediately.
In case you didn't understand that, he said, I need to get a letter to Nebus Glonk immediately.
Nebus! 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 I got evidence that Guster Brown is innocent. We both reopen the investigation and find who is truly at the bottom of this. Nebus.
It was the bounty hunter.
Our first suspect in the reopened case, Mr. Joe Bison.
I was always disrespected by the townspeople. They were more grateful for the sheriff than for me.
I see you finally got up in this weak gunshot over here.
Yeah, I shot in the leg.
In the leg? Can you man up? You can still walk around, so we'll focus on this case. Okay, I've been looking. There's no evidence. There are too many people here to figure out who shot this guy. You got any ideas?
Well, you saw Guster bring his chips over to the bartender, correct?
Yeah.
If these are the too many cards, I have all these cards here, then Guster was sitting in this chair and shot the man at Pierston right here. So, I think Guster's.
That makes sense, Nate. That makes sense.
I mean,
Sheriff?
Yeah.
Can I get a report for the cameras?
Of course you can. Pick that up.
Alright, so basically, I was looking at this and I figured out that we walked in on Guster Brown getting his chips, cashing out, and that's the winning card, right? So, he had to have shot this man from right there because if he's sitting here and that man's there, then trajectory lines up. Perfect. I'm a genius.
Hey!
Sheriff Boomer.
Yeah?
Why do you tell my friend?
I solved the case, basically. I found out everything, dragged the body, and you do nothing, and still take all the credit.
Yeah, because I'm the sheriff. They know Sheriff Boomer. They know my name. Who are you? I don't think I know your name, okay? So they're gonna listen to me, not you. Makes sense to me.
Okay, Boomer.
Yeah.
I want that, man. I do everything. No one knows.
Mr. Bison, pleasure to have you today.
Alright, very well.
Why don't you go ahead and tell me about your relationship with the sheriff?
It was great. Best pals. Knew him for a while.
That's interesting, because that is not what I heard. I heard you were next in line to become sheriff if anything were to happen to him.
That is true, but I was happy for him.
Really?
Yep.
What if I had information that you killed the sheriff?
I would say you're lying.
Spill the beans.
So, Investigator Galang, what did you think about the last interview?
I'm gonna keep it G-real with you. I knew it wasn't him. I just wanted to do that.
Our second suspect of the case, Calibri Rockfall.
I hate Indians. They're so weird, and they're always eating those mushrooms. Like, what's with that?
Oh,
yo, there's one now.
That just messed up.
Get out of here! I hate Indians! Yeah, I wanna get you!
Joe, this is a great place to build a new saloon for the townspeople to really make them happy.
This is a great place to build a new saloon for the townspeople. Really
watch this.
Here.
No, it isn't.
Hey,
run! Run, Indian!
My brothers and sisters, I miss you. I will get revenge on the sheriff.
Time to catch some dinner.
Mr. Rockfall, how are we this evening? All right. What do you have to say for yourself?
The sheriff was a bad man. He took my land, brutally killed my people. There's nothing but tension between me and the sheriff. Still no reason for me to kill the man.
It's terrible. That's such a sob story. Let me tell you something. 5 years old, buddy. Living by myself, Fortune 500 company, and I was whooping my own ass. True story. Me having more integrity than you, as a 5-year-old and you're a grown man, pathetic. P-A-T-H-E-I-T-I-C. Okay, you understand me? Pathetic. So what I'm gonna do right here, I'm gonna arrest you.
So, Mr. Galanc, what gave you the decision to arrest Mr. Rockfall?
You know, after months of compiling all the evidence, deciphering everything, looking over every fact in the case, we came down to the decision. What it really came down to was, you know, he's a Native American. What is he doing? I could take it or leave it. He's out there eating grass. Okay. You know. Slammer.
Our third suspect of the case, Leviticus Cornwall.
So want a man right there.
So I call a classic compadre takedown.
I give some neat tips. Get her down.
Leviticus Cornwall, never missed a shot in my life.
They call me Speedy Leviticus, because I've never lost a draw.
Adios, amigos.
That's nasty. Howdy, partner and members of Strawberry Community College. Alumni myself, go Berries. Here I'm going to give you a tour of my arsenal, how I got so deadly. All right, starting off with my favorite, Big Betty. She's a beauty. Ugh, look at that. She does some damage. Boy, she kills. Don't mess with me when I'm mad and I got Big Betty in my position. That was given to me by my pops a couple years ago. Big fella, he died. Bear trap. Got his ass. All right, moving on. The big guns. I only got a bandit out and I'm on a big bounty. I chop him down like a tree. Gone. All right, moving on. Standy handy revolver. Everywhere I go, she go. We sleep together, but it's not sexual. Okay, on here. This is where I gotta go long range. I go down, pop a head if I got to. I like to get up close and personal. Cause that's a real bounty hunter. That's a real bounty hunter way. Last up, least but not last, man, the sucker tongue.
Leviticus, what did
y'all
you
cut?
Same procedure. We gotta do that every week. You know what I'm saying? We've been here before. Yeah. Nice. There we go. What did you do with Leviticus? How you been? That's tight. How's your family? Family's good. You know, Grace just had the baby. Yep. Uh, I'm not even sure this thing's mine. It's looking half Asian. She's white, I'm white. Right. So you think she cheated? How's the baby Asian? Is basically what I'm asking.
Want to take her out?
You can chisel that, because the one we were last time.
The whole situation. Right, right. Yeah. So you know why you're in here though? Yeah, we got a question. You know, I mean, yeah, yeah. Standard procedure. We, uh, yeah, we know who did it. Right, but like, who are you friends with? You know, Gusterbrown. Oh, that's blood, bruh. Gusterer. They'll buy it. Who's Guster? Guster. Guster. Names are kid. Guster. Guster. Loser. Right. L-O-S-S-E-R. Brain tart.
So, Mr. Glonk, how did you feel about that last interview? Any thoughts?
Oh, Leviticus Cornwall? No, he's a stand-up. He's a good guy in the community. No way he did it. Zilch. Zero wayo. That's for all my Spanish babes out there.
After some digging by the assistant, Joe Bison, it was found that the black gun used to kill Sheriff Boomer was in his possession.
For all I've been through, this is what you locked me up for.
Leviticus Cornwall, you've been found guilty for the murder of Sheriff Boomer.
Never
you've been sentenced to hang.
Never did such a thing. Nemus Glong! Nemus Glong sent me a check! $1 million! I didn't do this. I didn't do this. This isn't right. I was hired. Nevis Glonk, the head investigator, he hired me.
Stop trying to.
He had the evil intention.
Stop trying to save yourself, scum.
Boomer! I swear!
Bad shit. Word.
The bounty hunter was right. Son of a bitch. We hung the wrong person. This is the bounty hunter's room. We need to clean this place up so we can run back to the market. What's this? This looks like a check to the bounty hunter from the investigator. Right after Sheriff Boomer's death.
Investigator Nevis Glonk, you have been found the true murderer of Sheriff Boomer. You are sentenced to hang.
He killed my father!
Hang him! Hang him! Hang!
And so, with the hanging of Nevis Glonk, the true murderer of Sheriff Boomer, the town of Valentine was at peace.
Hey, Nevis!